Good evening, we're going to begin. Welcome to everyone. Welcome to the 35th Annual Induction Ceremony of the Old Colony Chapter of the National Honor Society. My name is Jennifer Hendricks and this is Danielle Harrison. We are the National Honor Society advisors. We are so grateful to have you all here to celebrate this momentous occasion.
We would like to begin our introduction of our inductees. Please stand as our inductees enter. Mr. Michael Parker, our principal, and Ms. Chris LaFay, our special services coordinator. At this time, we would like to invite our special services coordinator, Ms. Fay, to say a few words.
That I welcome you to this evening's ceremony and thank you all for being here. Your support for tonight's honorees is greatly appreciated. Thank you for sharing this special event with us. As I stand before you all today and we look toward these bright young stars before us, I cannot help but feel pride in their accomplishments and anticipation of what will come next. These students have been chosen to participate in a very prestigious organization. National Honor Society membership is invitation only and a very specific honor. And a particular welcome to our inductees. You have been characterized to share the values of our current and past membership. You have proven that you are good citizens worthy of such a recognition at this point in your young life. We are all here today to welcome you as the newest members of Old Colony's chapter of National Honor Society. Your actions, dedications, work ethic, intrinsic motivation, and perseverance have brought you to this point. You have all met the criteria for membership in this respected group. But your extraordinary effort cannot end at this induction and ceremonial welcome. There is great responsibility in your role as a member within the National Honor Society. This is the start of an exciting new chapter for you. As our newest members, you are the foundation of our chapter. We look to you to help us support our four pillars of membership from this point forward. The four pillars, scholarship, service, leadership, and character, are the base on which the NHS is built. Why are they called pillars? Is it because pillars are vertical and suggest ground-up strength and movement? Or could it be because pillars are a reliable support system in architecture and you are expected to be the support system of our community? What do you think? Are you up for it? Will I be saying to you, they understand the assignment? To help answer these questions, reflect on these four pillars. What do they mean to you? Your definition of these terms will be seen in your actions in the coming years. You will have numerous opportunities to demonstrate your understanding and values of these pillars. We are excited for you and can't wait to see what you do with these opportunities. We know that your actions will play a part in who you become, and we have the utmost confidence in you. I'd like to speak briefly about each of these pillars. Scholarship. Scholarship is not just about good grades. It's about learning at your highest level to your best ability. It's about honesty and integrity within your learning experiences. It's about getting the most out of your learning experience without cutting corners. It's about taking those risks and going for it when you are uncertain. Take time to enjoy the process of learning. Appreciate finding out how one bit of information connects to something else that you already know, and how each and every day you are building a web of knowledge that is specific to you and your interests. Look beyond what is required and enjoy diving to new depths of understanding. Share your enthusiasm for learning with those around you. Service. As part of your membership in the NHS, you will be required to perform community service hours. As I mentioned, the values you currently possess prompted an invitation to join the NHS, and that you will be growing during this endeavor. Of course, it is important that every person in a community gives back and assists others. This is why community service is one of the pillars of NHS. Throughout these efforts, focus on others and put aside your personal agenda. We hope this experience will give your self-confidence, self-esteem, and self-worth a positive boost. Leadership. Student leaders are resourceful, good problem solvers, and idea contributors. Leadership is not about being the boss, your job title, or your level of pay. It's not about having authority over others or how you can influence others to see things your way. Leadership is about maximizing outcomes in a positive manner towards a shared goal. Leaders utilize their communication skills, which includes, most importantly, listening. They help others see their strengths and values as team members. They encourage, they support, and they are driven by how to make things better for everyone. They determine how well they are doing by how accomplished those around them feel. Character. NHS says that a student of good character is cooperative, demonstrates high standards of honesty and reliability, shows courtesy, concern, and respect for others. Do you see how these pillars demonstrate the values that we want you to embody? It's about continuing on daily to be the best you. Keep positive, accept help, share your strengths, persevere, find what makes you smile, and most importantly, be you. We are proud of your accomplishments and are happy that we can recognize you for them. It is with great enthusiasm that we look towards your future and who you will become as productive young adults and citizens. We stand before you and promise to help you along the way, throughout the steps of your journey. We wish you the best and know you will move confidently in the direction of your dreams. Thank you, Ms. Fay. At this time, we would like to take a moment to recognize one of our most supportive and generous parents. Our events would not be the same without the help and donations of this person. No matter what we ask of her or what we may need, she is always available at a moment's notice. She is the most selfless, kind, and giving person. Her son has inherited all of his mother's wonderful attributes
and she should be extremely proud of the young man he has become. Please join me in a very special round of applause for Mrs. Mary Ann Walker. The National Honor Society Old Colony Chapter President, Mr. Chaz Aguiar.
Leadership. Leadership should exert a wholesome influence on the school in taking the initiative in class and school activities. The real leader strives to train and aid others to attain the same objective. The price of leadership is sacrifice and the willingness to yield one's personal interest for the interest of others. A leader has self-confidence and will go forward when others hesitate. No matter what power and resources may exist in a country, they are ineffectual without the guidance of a wise leader. Leadership is always needed. Thus, to lead is an important charge to each of our members and the candidates.
Scholarship. Scholarship means a commitment to learning. A student is willing to spend hours reading and studying, knowing the lasting benefits of a cultivated mind. We should continue to learn even when formal education has ended, for education ends only with life. Knowledge is one great element in life which leads to the highest success, and it can be acquired in only one way, through diligence and effort. Learning furnishes the lamp by which we read the past and the light which illuminates the future. Candidates have the charge to continually expand their world through the opportunities inherent in scholarship.
We'll put new candles on the budget for next year.
Service. Service can be described in various ways. In the routine of the day's work, many opportunities arise to help others. Willingness to work for the benefits of those in need, without monetary compensation or without recognition, is the quality we seek in our membership. We are committed to the idea of volunteering our time and abilities to the creation of a better tomorrow.
Character. Character is the force within each individual that distinguishes that person from others. It gives each one individuality. It is that without which no one can respect oneself, nor hope to attain the respect of others. It is this force of character which guides one through life and, when once developed, grows steadily. Character is achieved and not received. It is the product of constant attention, daily striving to make the right choice. By demonstrating such qualities as reliability, honesty, and sincerity, we may hope to prove, by example, what we value character.
I swear they were working earlier. We would now like to take a moment to recognize our outstanding National Honor Society officers. These four students were chosen to hold these prestigious positions for not only their commitment to the National Honor Society, but for embracing the pillars and exceeding expectations and requirements. Chaz Aguiar, Felicity Kulak, Allison Bumpus, and Megan Correa. At this time, I would now like to introduce our Honor Society inductees by presenting their certificates and new member pin. Brianna Aruda. Lindsay Bakayaki. William Baker. Benjamin Barriga. McKenna Benoit. Derek Costa. Tyler Colomb. Alyssa Kudo. Christopher Darcy. Olivia D'Souza. Owen Flynn. Thomas Graber. Ethan Gray. Alicia Griffin. Austin Hall. Isabel Hogassian.
Yeah!
Evan LaPointe. Bruce Maxey. Brianna Mello. Finn Pereira. Abigail Pitts. Owen Quinn. Alexandros Sedell. Todd Soares. Trevor Studley. J. Walden Scotts. Aiden Walker. Rachel Wilworth. And Andrew Ronsky. Congratulations. Chaz Aguiar, our president, will now lead the Honor Society pledge on behalf of our inductees.
Will the inductees please stand and repeat after me? I pledge myself to uphold the high purposes of National Honor Society, to which I have been selected at STAMS. I will be true to the principles for which it stands. I will be loyal to my school. I will maintain and encourage the high standards of scholarship, service, leadership, and character.
Mrs. Hendricks and I would be remiss if we failed to extend our appreciation to the individuals who made this evening possible: the district school committee, the administration, the faculty council, the parents and families of our National Honor Society members, Old Colony staff who helped us prepare for this evening, Mrs. Peterson, Mr. Bob Souza, the entire maintenance department. In conclusion, we congratulate our inductees on this honor. You are truly the best of the best. Remember, however, that being a National Honor Society member is a privilege, and with that privilege comes responsibility. You are expected to be a role model for others, a leader within the student body, a contributor to your community, and must continue commitment to academic and vocational excellence. As we end our ceremony, we would like to leave our inductees with this message: let your dreams be bigger than your fears, and your actions be louder than your words. Thank you all for coming tonight. Please stay and mingle, take some pictures, enjoy some refreshments in the back, and we would like to really thank all of you for joining us for this really momentous occasion.
Thank you.